Well, I usually don't do sports, but everybody's got something to say about Richard Sherman. He's the Seattle Seahawks cornerback whose post-game antics on their way to the Super Bowl set the Twitterverse a-buzzing. Lots of knuckleheads out there calling him the N-word, even more using the word thug, which Sherman took offense at, a particular offense, and so did a lot of African Americans who say, well, isn't that just typical to use a word like that to talk about a young African American male who happens to have dreadlocks, but also a degree from Stanford, and a rather admirable background in most ways. Well, you know, this is an interesting argument. Because, frankly, I can think of a lot of other causes I like to really lay down in the streets for, other than the career of Richard Sherman. But this whole question about the word thug and having racial connotations, I'm reminded of the old saying that it's not what you say, it's what other people hear. And here we see a real cultural racial divide insofar as what people hear the word like that connotating. But let's not have any confusion about this. As far as I'm concerned, when I first saw Sherman on the tube, I thought right away, he's looking like a thug. Whether he wants to or not, that was the message he was sending with his yelling at the camera, with that kind of swagger that has become pretty common in professional sports these days. You can call me old-fashioned, but I think that our athletes are role models for our young people. And they need all the good role models they can get. You know, it's true that he may not be a thug, but he played one on TV. And all athletes, whether they want to or not, are playing role models on TV. And I'm Clarence Page.